Welcome back. Well, Kevin Drew is the founder and frontman of Toronto's indie rock orchestra, Broken Social Scene. During the supergroup's time off, Drew has continued to be hard at work. His second solo album, Darlings, examines the most intimate parts of modern relationships. Good sex, it's gonna take you in the highlight. Good sex, it's gonna take you actually. And we're pleased to welcome back Kevin Drew. And Mrs. Drew, if you're watching at home, you can reveal your eyes now.
Right. Let's talk about that video for a minute. Whose idea was it? Like, how do you get in the mind space with a crew around to just like, woof?
Well, the crew was the reason it all came together. And a great director named Samir Rahan, he helped out in putting it all together and orchestrating it. And we auditioned real couples. Because we wanted it to be real couples being intimate on camera. And I was sort of... They represented love, and I represented lust, and I was beat up and bruised and all alone.
So how do you put out a casting call? Looking for real couples to have sex on music video?
We said looking for real couples to be intimate.
Oh, sorry.
You underplayed it then.
Yes, we did. We were looking for vulnerability.
Were some people too eager?
Most weren't, but most were shocked with their performances.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of them were very nervous going into it, and then by the time we said cut, thank you, a lot they didn't realize that it was 20 minutes that they were up there.
Talk about your vulnerability now.
Vulnerability, let's talk about it.
It's honest, it's open, and it's also very personal.
Yeah, it's all those things. And
very revealing.
Yeah, well, that's the only way I think in today's day and age I've been saying that I think honesty is the most innovative thing you have going, and I find it very cold out there and stifling, and I think that people gravitate towards some warmth, and that was just the goal that I was trying to create with this album, was something to be comforting, some compassion, some tenderness, things that are a dying breed in today's day and age. So
you consider yourself a failed romantic, is that true? And why?
I'm 37 years old. I've been blessed with lots of lovely people in my life, and still to this day, I surround myself with beautiful people. If you see me walking around with anyone, it's because I think that they're champions, and I love people. I have my whole life. I get a lot of energy from people. I get a lot of energy from strangers, and I like to find the good ones, and some people I don't see anymore, and others I still do, but I've had a lot of love in my life, and I always love honoring that whenever I'm making records or getting on stage and trying to make all the shows celebrations and reaching out and screaming, let's live our lives, let's forgive ourselves, let's keep going, failures and all, we can keep doing this. And that's sort of the message I'm trying to get across. I'm human. I make mistakes. You know, am I seeing people? Yes. Am I not? Yes. It's just all a big confusion of wearing your heart on your sleeve. But at the end of the day, I turn to my friends, and I turn to my family, and I turn to my loved ones, and I just want to give them bear hugs for more than 25 minutes.
Let's talk about that. You worked with Andy Kim.
Yep. Who loves him, by the way, and says so every day. In fact, I have this little joke that he would leave his wife Summer for you, sir.
Summer's incredible, so that would be,
she is.
A little much. There'd be some pressure on me. Yeah. I don't know if that would change the dimensions of our relationship, but yes.
So here he is at the age of 17. He has huge success, writes Sugar Sugar for the Archies. You know, countless hits through time, and then back again, has a second career with Rock Me Gently.
Yeah.
And now you two are sitting in studio together. I would not see you guys in the same
like
sphere.
Musically it
really?
Seems like two different universes.
Well, you know, he bases his life on energy, which is a wonderful thing, and he bases his life on a youthful way of believing in magic and believing in music. And when he came into the room with myself, and we had a lovely gentleman, Ohad Benchatrit, and another lovely gentleman, Dave Hamlin, who we worked on this record with, he would just sort of just give us that feeling of why you're there in the first place. And he put that belief in sound back for me, in melody, and just the idea of when you have nothing to lose, that's the greatest place to be. It's the greatest place to be standing. And I'm very grateful for him. It helped me create the record that I've created now that I'm out here promoting, just on the basis of he loves. That's what he does. Andy is a lover. He walks around the world with his arms this wide open. He doesn't close himself down. And he has saying after saying of
great things about it. It's your life. You're the director of your own life. It's your film. Make the movie that you want. And he's very encouraging. And coming out of just a very confusing time and, you know, my personal life, my business life, my creative life, and everything just all fusing together, because that's just the way I live. He was wonderful to me, and as I've said before, I lean on my friends. I lean on the people that I spend my time with. I've got a lot of beautiful people. I've got a lot of beautiful women. I've got a lot of beautiful boys. I've got a lot of beautiful, you know, adults and fathers and mothers in my life. And with Andy, it's just a celebration of all those things, and he makes you look around and really see what it is that's genuine and worth it. How was that?
That's awesome. Yeah. Well, and you're makes very me want to go talk to Andy Kim, too. Yeah.
Well, we're going to come back in the fall when his album comes out.
Yes.
Yeah, that's right. Where did he learn all that, I wonder? Did he tell you?
He's lived. Yeah. You know, and he's had highs and he's had lows. And the wonderful thing about hanging out with some of the people that are, you know, older in this business is that you see where they end up and how they've landed on their feet and how they are their own selves through, because you're constantly in a narcissistic kind of way. You're constantly, it's very vain and it's very egotistical, and you're trying to figure out things, and it's very much a competition. And it's nice to see balanced people with their lives, making peace with their failures and their achievements and things that have worked and things that haven't. And I learn a lot from that. I've been around a lot of reunions, Pavement, Dinosaur Jr. I've seen them firsthand, and it's great to just see people putting things aside and moving forward musically with their lives.
Kevin, we have to go soon, but yeah. I just want to ask you about Darlings. The album is out tomorrow. How would you describe it?
I would just say I'm here to say we got to keep going. We got to keep moving forward. It's about being close, and it's about being real, I just look back at my life and I look forward at my life, and I don't really think about it too much, but my heart pounds a lot and I feel it all and I feel it too much, and this is it.
In a few words, what would be your advice to young musicians who turn to you and look at you as a role model at a time when, you know, the music industry was changing? You guys carved a niche out for yourself.
Yeah, keep it honest. Be yourselves. Keep it honest. Make it real and you'll cut through.
All right.
And that's it.
Thank you so much for being
Thanks
here.
For
You'll also
me,
be
guys.
On The Late Show with David Letterman on the 3rd.
Yes, I'll be
cool.
there.
That's awesome.
Wow, that's always
Kevin
cool.
Drew, thank you so much.
All right.